What's up, guys? We are here, Royal Revolt 2, and I'm checking out some new attack strategies here. So, thinking of trying things a little bit different. And as you can see here, we got the Sword Ring coming back into play. Reason being, the Sword Ring is really effective. They buffed it up against ogres. So, it used to be almost able to one-shot kill ogres, and now they've buffed it so it pretty much can one-shot kill ogres. And that's a big thing. Depending on elite boost ogres or not, you might not be able to kill. Our Sword Rain is only level, I think, 10 right now, so it's not max. We are upgrading it, as you can see here. And then the other big issue is that, figuring that we don't necessarily need the Bladestorm anymore, because we do have these supercharged knights. You can see, look at the speed stat on these guys. They're 2.72. These knights are, I believe, plus 12 right now. So they are insanely high stat-wise on that foraging there. So let's go ahead and take a look. This base should be an easy base here. 32 medals. But this does seem to work pretty well. So you got the archers in there just as the cleanup crew to help finish off. And so against the elite boosted ogres right there, it almost kills them in one shot. So if the ogres are not elite boosted, they will definitely kill them in one shot. We've tested that out before. Overall, even doing a 70 to 80% of their damage right now as a level 10 Sword Rain, that's a pretty nice chunk of damage to be doing to the elite boosted ogres. And the rest of our troops should be able to easily finish them off. As you can see there, that ogre came up to us. He took two Sword Rains and down he went. Tumbling ogre. You know, the bigger they are, the harder they fall. And the insane speed of these knights is really cool. So it's like they run past most of the traps, most of the bombs. Don't really hit them. You're going to see, unless they're stuck up on those barricades and things like that, most of the time they're not really taking a lot of damage from the skull towers because they're moving just too damn fast now. That's a very, very big plus. You can see it's just a near endless wave of troops as well. So hopefully we can take and find a, you know, a stronger metal base. We're pushing a little bit higher than we have been before. So we're around 3,800 trophies. And with the other attacking strategies, we're hovering right around the 3,700, like 50 mark. So this is definitely a better attacking strategy here that we found. We've gained around 70 or so trophies. And you see we have tons and tons of time left. 50 odd seconds there. They melt down that castle gate. I mean, the knight spam is just real. So let's go find a harder base here and see if we can go and crush them like we did before. So yeah, see, we're at 3849 right now. So I'm just gonna look for metals here. Just to try and find a base that's got a lot of metals, which means it's a hard base to beat. Oh, look at all those loot, guys. Man, 600, 700, 500,000. We just passed up so much loot. Yeah, the new loot system is just insane. Come on, guys. Alright, so here's a high one. 328. There is little to no elite boost, it looks like, in here. But his tower levels are extremely high. A lot of people fail on this base. So, Sword Rain one-shots all of the Arb Blasters there. So his Fireball Towers did a decent amount of damage. Took us a little while to get past his first initial wave, thanks to his tower levels. And you can see this is why it's a 300 metal base here. The towers are very, very high level. We're, you know, barely, I don't even think we were able to kill a Fireball Tower there with one Sonic Blast. That's pretty impressive tower leveling on that Firebolt Tower there. Cannot even take it out with one Sonic Blast. So we scream to bring back to get some health. And we're also going to take out those Fireball Towers as our troops are getting stuck. Right over here in this choke point. But we needed HP. So it's going to be a tight race here. We got 30 some odd seconds. Takes out that entire wave with that Sonic or that Sword Rain. Can't we do it? 13 seconds. Clock is ticking away. Oh, and there's the reinforcements. 4 seconds left over. So, obviously we didn't play that round perfectly. But we still beat the base there. How many trophies did we pick up? Picked up 14 trophies, 328 medals. A decent chunk of medals right there. Picked up 2 Chamber of Fortune chests. Alright, so let's see. Maybe we can find a little bit difficulter base. Ooh. Do we have enough bread? I want to take the 800,000. It's not a little bit difficulter. It's only 120 odd medals. But it has 800,000 loot. I just can't pass it up right now. I'm getting greedy. I want the loot. So we'll scream right there to bring those guys up. Help the knights finish the ogres off. And you can see the Sword Rain also, we have buffed it up to has a 4 second stun on it, or a 0.4 second stun. So it has a little slight stunning ability in there as well. The shield spell has a little bit of a healing ability. So we stun there, so we get a little stun on the towers. Kill all those Frosters. And it's all Shiro, guys. This is a massacre. It's the Million Knight Army. Oh, well, so that Sword Rain was unable to one-shot the elite boosted archers. Scream to take that off. Sadly, we won't be able to kill both of the Fireball Towers. Maybe we will. Their stunning ogres are doing a good job at stun-locking the troops. It will buy us enough time to actually get our second Sonic Blast. So that's why I didn't use the Scream to take off that stun there. I wanted to buy time for my Sonic Blast so I could take down both sides. Worked out well. So definitely upgrading the Sonic Blast to level 11 should be able to one-shot kill the elite boosted ogres. So it could be very, very interesting, this Sword Rain attack squad with knights. Maybe something to try out, guys. Give it a shot. Let me know what you think about Sword Rain in the new meta. Thanks for watching. Hit that like, share, and subscribe button. I'll talk to you guys later. Peace.